May the showers of blessing be with you, dear listeners of the Voice of Reformation. You are with Jean Gentil and Aishimie. The topic of today is the danger of idleness and the benefits of working. Before we move forward, shall we pray? Our Father, what's above, we say thank you for your protecting power upon our lives. We say thank you for all your mercies, which is new every morning. May your name be glorified. Forgive our sins as we pray. We are about to learn your word. Please send your Holy Spirit to help us to understand and to help us so that we may not only be the hearer of your word, but be the doer of your word. In Jesus' name I do pray. Amen. As I said, the topic of today is the danger of idleness. Jesus is a constant worker. That's why when he desired the human being, he didn't want him to remain idle. He gave him a garden to take care of, as it is written in the book of Genesis chapter 2 verse 15. It reads, "And the Lord God took the man and put him into the garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it." That Jesus, he didn't want a human being to remain idle. He knew that there are many benefits of working. That's why he gave to him a garden to take care of. Many people, they think that a labor is a curse, working is a curse, but work is not a curse, working is a blessing. There are many benefits of working. First of all, to work close the door of many temptations. When you are working, when you are laboring, it reduces the chance of sinning. Let's see the example of the King David, which is written in the book of 2 Samuel chapter 11 verse 2. It reads, "And it came to pass in an evening tide that David arose from off his bed and walked upon the roof of the king's house. And from the roof he saw a woman washing herself. And the woman was very beautiful to look upon." That was David. All the Israelites and the army, they went in war. But David, he remained in the palace. He remained idle, doing nothing. The Bible said that he was just roaming around and he saw a woman washing herself. And that woman was very beautiful. He desired her and they slept together. And that sin that he committed, it brings the door of many sins. He killed the husband of that wife. He did many things after committing adultery. If he was in the war, he couldn't do all those sins. But because he was idle, roaming around, he saw the woman and then he committed adultery with that woman. So for really walking close the door of temptation, and to be idle, open front of brain and muscles and spiritual growth. When you are working, your muscles become strong and it protects you from many diseases. Your brain, it becomes strong and you grow spiritually. We know that the thing that helps us to grow spiritually is to read the Bible, is to pray, and to go to preach the gospel unto others. So if you are not working, you can't grow spiritually. It is connected. If you are not laboring, you can't grow spiritual. That's another benefit of working. That's why in Proverbs chapter 14 verse 23 say that every handwork will bring a profit. In all the profit that the handwork will bring, even the spiritual growth is included. Let's move to the third benefit of working. Working help us to be rich. We get food. As it is written in Proverbs chapter 10 verse 4, it reads, "He become poor that dealeth with a slack hand, but the hand of the diligent make him rich." When you are working, you become rich. You will get something to supply your needs. That's why nowadays there are many prostitutes, there are many thieves, there are many lies, there are many murderers, because they don't want to work. If you are not working, you will desire many things. And if you see that you don't have any way to get those things, you start to do the bad thing. You start misbehaving so that you may supply our needs. So working will help us to supply our needs. We won't desire anything. The last benefit of working, it helps us to be satisfied. The work brings satisfaction, as it is written in the book of Proverbs chapter 20 verse 13. It reads, "The soul of the sluggard desireth and has nothing, but the soul of the diligent shall be made fat." Amen. The soul of an idle person desire many things, but he get nothing. But the soul of the diligent worker gets everything. So working brings satisfaction. You get all you want. It brings happiness. In Ecclesiastes, they say that even the sleep of a hard worker is very sweet. He becomes satisfied. It says that in Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 12, it reads, "The sleep of a laboring man is sweet, whether he eat little or much, but the abundance of the rich will not suffer him to sleep." That's very true. Working brings satisfaction. Working brings joy. Working brings happiness. So in short, those are some benefits of working. It closes the door of temptation. It helps to increase the strength of brain and muscles. We get rich. We get the satisfaction. We supply our needs. And another thing, we have seen that working brings satisfaction. It brings joy and happiness. So let's see, in short, some danger of idleness. The science has proved that when someone is active, he's working, the blood circulates properly, the lungs extend properly. So when you are not working, when you are idle, when you are lazy, your lungs are not expanding, and the oxygen reduces in lung, in the blood, and in the brain. So the reduction of oxygen in the blood and in the brain cause the following problem. It makes you to remain lazy every time. You become lazy every time, and then you become weak. Even your bones become weak because you are not active, because you are not working. Jesus was wise enough to provide to human being a labor, because he knew that there are many benefits of working. When he will be working, he will be active, and all his body will work properly. My brothers and sisters, when we are saying about working, we are not only mentioning the daily labor, we are saying even to work for Christ, because we know that we have to work for our salvation. It is written in Ecclesiastes chapter 9 verse 10, say that whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with thy might, for there is no work, no device, no knowledge, no wisdom in the grave whither thou goest. Soon we die. Soon we will die. Soon we expire. So we have to work while we are still alive. And we have to prepare our end while we are still alive. Because we have seen that in grave, there is no knowledge. There is no device. There is no anything in the grave. We have to prepare our end while we are still alive. And we can't prepare our end when we are idle. Because we have seen that to grow spiritually, we have to work hard. So the idle won't make it. So let's change our mind. Let's now start to see a labor not as a curse, but as a blessing. Parents, don't Don't prevent your children from the labor, because when you are protecting them from working, you are training them to be the future prostitute, to be the future thief, and to be the future murderers. Give them the work, train them to work, and we enjoy the fruits in the future. They will reduce your burden when you will be old. May God bless you all, and may He help us to change our mind. May He give us His Spirit, the Spirit of working, in Jesus' name.